I will present you now the item 10 of this course, which is named Magnetic and Electric Fields and Their Effects. We'll speak about concepts and mapping of magnetic and electric fields. In this video, we'll speak about the concepts for the calculation of magnetic and electric fields near a set of electric conductors, as we find in complete substations and inside a switchgear, a panel, or a switchboard. The calculations will be based on classic equations for fields near a single conductor, and they can be validated by real measurements using field metering instruments. We'll explain also about the method used in the software switchgear design, which basically use these basic classic equations for each conductor and sum the contributions of the several conductors inside the substation to get the values of the field in any point of the substation. Of a typical study of electrical and magnetic fields in a 138 kV substation. I prepared this study some 2 years, 2 to 3 years ago, for one specific substation which was under construction, and this study was necessary to be sent to the regulator organism in my country. And when I say general public, I say people different from, let's say, substation operator, people which may be walking near the substation and are not, let's say, skilled people related to the electric power. For the magnetic fields, the values are 200 microtesla. And for the occupational population, when there are some numbers which are characterizing the conductors that will be used for effects of visualization of the results, and in the substation that is in the left side in blue, one control room, one small control room, and there are two transformers which convert the voltage from the 138 kV level to the level of 13.8 kV. And the base, the actual field would be the vectorial sum of the fields produced. And this would lead to a much lower value. This value would be something like only 14 microtesla. Even if there was a total load of 2 times 20 MVA connected to the station, the current in the 138 kV cables would never be more than 170 amps. So, you see, we are doing the calculations with 510 amps, 3 times more. Then, we are calculating values which are much higher than the visualization of all the fields. Same here for the electric fields, the same approach, just for you to enable you to do the comparisons. And here in another positions for the electric fields, the good way of checking the values here is to take the PDF file that you may find in the when you acquire the video lesson, and you take a look at first in this video, and after you go following step by step using the PDF file. Normally the case in this kind of test, or even in phase-to-phase circuits, the magnetic fields near the conductors are very high, but if you go some meters far from the passage, place where the currents are passing,